guys, so today I'm here with a new fall background and cat ears and a Glitterature. It's just the best kind of night. So today I'm gonna do a Glitterature on The Jewel. I actually listened to this book on my Audible app, but I found a picture of the cover art on Safari. This is what it looks like. It's called The Jewel by Amy Ewing. If you can see it without my ring light blinding you in the reflection, it has a beautiful cover art. I think that's so pretty. This is actually one of those books where I kind of wish I had the actual book because the cover art is so gorgeous. And it says, "The power to choose comes with a price." I would categorize this book in the dystopian genre, and I did tell you guys that I was starting to get kind of bored with that genre of book, and I did actually stray away from it. I read some books that were totally outside of the dystopian type world, which I feel like has just overwhelmed all of the aisles of bookstores these days. But this one was recommended to me by someone, and I tried it, and I loved it. I loved it. So even if you're kind of getting tired of dystopian books, but you like it, you're just kind of bored of it, this is a good one. Because I feel like the last few that I've read haven't really sucked me in the way the Delirium trilogy did, the Divergent trilogy, and the Hunger Games trilogy. Those three were incredible. It is about a world where you have a city called the Jewel, and then you have a bunch of other cities lining it in a circle like an onion, layers, and each one gets poorer. So it's kind of like the Hunger Games with the capital in the middle and then different districts, and each layer is a very specific thing. So you have like the smoke, which has all the factories, and you have the bank, which has all of the shops, and you have the farm, which does all of the, like, you know, farming and stuff. Is it called the farm? It might be called something else, and it does the farming. And then on the very outer layer, you have the marsh, which is kind of equivalent to District 13. It's the poorest, and it's very poverty-stricken, and our main girl of the book is from that district, naturally, right? And then in the very center, you have the Jewel, which is all of the royalty, nobility, and most people never even see it because it's right in the middle, and you have to be nobility or royalty to be there. Okay, so the premise of the story is that in this world, the royalty and the nobility, for whatever reason, can't bear their own kids. There's some genetic something something, and they can't have their own kids. Obviously, they have to have kids because they are royalty, and royalty is all about genetics and passing on their line through blood. And so they find out that the people in the marsh, some of the women in the poorest region of the marsh, can actually still have kids. I don't know if it explains it in the book. If it did, I just skimmed right on past it and didn't soak it in. It might have had some explanation with radiation or something. I don't know, I'm making that up. If you're a female and you live in the marsh, at a certain age you get tested to see if you can be a surrogate for the royal families. And if you do have the gene, you don't have a choice. You're taken away from your family and you're put in a surrogacy house, and you're trained in these magical skills. So there's definitely a fantasy element to this book series because there are like magic things that you learn how to do. They're called the Arguries. I might be saying that wrong. And they don't really explain what they do until like the middle to end of the book. And I think that's a spoiler, so I'll talk about that in a second. I'll give you guys a spoiler warning. But these girls are essentially slaves because they don't have a choice, and they are auctioned off in a surrogate auction once they hit a certain age and they've gone through all of their training. And the royal families just come and bid on them like slaves in the olden days, and they don't have a say in it, and they're slaves for life. You have to have their kids. Doesn't matter if you don't want kids. Doesn't matter if you want your own kids. You don't have any say in it. But a lot of these people are excited to be picked because they come from these really poor families, and they know that they get to live in the royal houses, and they're treated really well as surrogates. Like, they get to be treated as a member of the family and taken care of for the rest of their lives. So it does have a lot of prestige behind it. And our main girl named Violet, who lives in this outer marsh area, gets selected, obviously. And it kind of, the book takes her through being in the surrogacy house all the way through being auctioned and being selected by a family, and then going and living in the Jewel with her family. And a lot of stuff kind of starts happening, and you find out that living in the Jewel is actually, as a surrogate, is actually not a very nice experience. there's a lot of wickedness and a lot of backstabbing going on amongst the royal and the noble families, and it's just a lot of bad stuff is kind of going on behind the scenes. And you also find out what the arguries are, arguries that they're learning in their surrogacy school. So this is going to be a mild spoiler. I mean, I think it's a spoiler. I was kind of surprised when I found out what they're for in the book, but it's not like a life-changing, if you listen to the rest of this literature, you're never going to want to read this book. So starting now, the arguries are actually the ability to change the baby inside of your womb. And the better you are, the higher your auction number was. You're actually sorted according to your augury skill in school, and the best people get sold to the best houses for the most money. And of course, our lead girl is like one of the top 10 because she has to be, because it's what the book is about. But basically, they have the ability to change the baby inside of their womb. They can either make them really pretty, they can affect the way they look, they can affect their personality to an extent, and they can also affect how fast the baby grows. Like, you can have a baby faster than 9 months if you needed to. So it can control those three things: growth, color, which is like the looks of everything, hair color, eye color, and then I forget what the third one's called, but it's basically like personality or skills. So a lot of the surrogates that are really sought after have a skill. Our main girl can play the cello, and some girls can dance and some can sing. Like, they have a really artsy skill that kind of the royal families are hoping they kind of infuse into their baby magically. So, I mean, the idea behind it's really cool. And what's scary about this entire dystopian world in this book is that I could see how it could happen in real life. Not the magic thing. Obviously, we can't like affect what babies look like in our womb, but I could see how if all of a sudden the majority of people couldn't have kids anymore, and there was a certain group of people that could, and they were poor and you were rich, why? I mean, people do it already. Like, there are surrogates, you know, you can pay it if you have money. But as far as like an entire society doing it, I can see how that could turn into something like that. And that's what makes it a little bit scary, because these girls don't have a choice and they're essentially slaves, and they don't want that life. You know, they don't want to be ripped away from their family. They don't want to not be able to fall in love and have their own kids. Their lives are basically given up. And yes, they are treated relatively well living with the royals. They're still known as surrogates, and they're treated as like second-class citizens. Like, they're treated differently than everyone else. So of course there's like a boy that comes into the picture. Of course you have to have that in a dystopian book. And it leaves on a cliffhanger, and I wish that it didn't, because I want to know what happened now. I don't want to have to wait for the sequel. I feel very selfish with this book. I want to know right now. I feel like that with every book that I really like, but the fact that I feel that so strongly about this book means this book is very good. It reminds me of a little bit of a mix between The Hunger Games and The Selection series, because you have like that royal aspect to it. And I also felt, sorry, I'm like looking at the cover. I have it pulled up on my iPad. If you're wondering like what I'm looking at over here, that's what. It's helping me with my thoughts. Apparently not very well, right? There's also something going on with her best friend and the person that bought her, and I'm not really sure what it is, but I am so curious, and so I Googled it, and there's actually an ebook coming out. It's not out yet, but it's either an ebook or like one of those novellas, like the shorter little books that authors sometimes put out in between books, and it's about her story, and I'm so excited to read that because I'm really curious. They built it up a lot in this book, what was happening to her, and kind of checked in on her a couple times, but you have no clue what's going on behind closed doors in her palace and in her world. So really, really curious about that, and definitely something to check out if you read this book and you like it. I thought that the world building of this book was really good too. I felt like I knew what people looked like and what the buildings looked like and what the palace looked like and the outfits. And I think that that really helps me feel like I'm immersed in a book, as opposed to some books that don't really do a good job at building the world around your character, and you don't quite have a good grasp on what it looks like in the story. And so I thought that was really good about this book. I highly recommend it. If you are into anything dystopian, if you liked the Selection series and Yeah, I would definitely recommend it. I really, really enjoyed it. And I listened to it as I decorated and as I cleaned. And it was just a great old time. It was a good book. It was lighthearted. It was quick. I actually went through it way too quick. Lee, my mom would get so mad at me if she was watching this video. Quickly, Elle. If you guys have read it, leave me a comment below telling me how you liked it. And if you have any recommendations for future books, that's where I got this recommendation and it was amazing. So I heart you guys. Please leave me recommendations below. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.